it's the middle of the week, but we hope to take away the hump this Wednesday. Good morning. I'm Jiminita Swain, and I'm sure we've all been enjoying these cooler temperatures. But to get an idea of what weather will be like today, Chief Meteorologist Basil Dean joins us live in studio with the details. Good morning, Basil.
Bahamas, the bank of solutions.
Good morning, Jim Anita. With 10 days remaining in the tropical cyclone season, we have Tropical Storm Sebastian out there about 235 miles northeast of the northern Leeward Islands. It's moving towards the northwest at about 8 miles per hour. Maximum sustained winds now at 50 miles per hour. But this system will be caught up with this front boundary, so no problem for us here in the Bahamas. It will take it towards the north in time and then eventually towards the northern east. That will keep us, Sebastian, over the open waters of the Atlantic. But we have weak front boundary that went through that will reinforce the cool conditions for another few days, but outside of our studios, mostly cloudy skies. Temperature at 72 degrees here, relative humidity 82%, east-northeast winds at 6 miles per hour, the barometric pressure 1,016.7 millibars, that's 30.02 inches, and it is rising. Temperatures around the islands this morning in Greentoil Key, it's 70 degrees, 67 in Marsh Harbor, 70 degrees in Freeport, Grand Bahama, and the Berry Islands, 73 also in Arlestown, Bimini, 73 again in Harper Island, Roxanne, Elutra, Arlestown, Cat Island, at 74. 71 in Standing Key, Kemp's Bay, St. Andrews at 71. 70 degrees in Fresh Creek, Central Andrews, San Salvador at 74. Rum Key, 74 degrees in Ragged Island, Clarence Sound, Long Island, Crooked Island, 76. We're picking up some 78 in Betsy Bay, Miguana, also Acklands at 78. 79 in Magic Town, Inagua, and the Turks and Caicos Island. And if you're traveling this morning, here are some high and low temperatures you're likely to find at some of your favorite cities. Travel forecast now for you boaters today. For all areas, we're going to have a northerly flow at about 12 to 18 knots, wave heights around 3 to 6 feet over the ocean. That will make a moderate chop, so there's going to be a little temp out there on the ocean. Not the best day for boating, but nevertheless, we ask you to exercise some caution. Low tide will take place at 7:34 this morning, the high tide at 1:51 in the afternoon. And that's going to do it for your first look at weather, the morning edition. Stay tuned. Your forecast for today and tonight is still ahead.
Well, thanks, Basil. You're looking at a live shot from our tower cam of Shirley Street, but we find out from our traffic team with Kelsey Johnson, who is standing by to find out what you need to know in preparing for your morning commute. Kelsey, good morning.
The traffic report is sponsored by Bahamas First. First in insurance, today, tomorrow.
Good morning, Jiminita. Good morning, Bahamas. We're here on Wolf Road and Collins Avenue. As it relates to traffic on this road, it is flowing smoothly, but I just want to remind the general public, especially those traveling westbound on Shirley Street, that there is an unpaved trench not too far from the St. Margaret's Church. There's also an open trench on Nassau Street right in front of the Super Wash Wash House, so we want to remind the general public traveling on those particular corridors to drive with due caution and care. As it relates to Wolf Road and Collins Avenue, we have a steady flow of traffic, not too much to talk about, but we still want the general public to be reminded that a lot of pedestrians use this particular thoroughfare to access bus stops or walking or taking their children to school. Now, joining me live this morning is Sergeant Jerron Thompson, who will give us an update on overnight traffic matters as well as it relates to that dangerous curve right there on Collins Avenue. Good morning, Sergeant Thompson. How are you this morning on this chilly but beautiful Wednesday morning?
Good morning to you. Good morning, Bahamas. I'm very good.
As it relates to the curve right there on Collins Avenue, can you tell us how we are supposed to traverse, who has the right of way, and what is the speed limit heading or going around that?
Well, the speed limit in this area is 30 miles per hour. Persons who are traveling around the curve, you have to brake because it's a very deep curve. And if you don't brake, you'll find yourself drifting in the right lane, which can cause a collision. So we need persons to be mindful of that. You have to brake because that is a very deep curve, and especially if you have ball tires, it can be an issue for you. And also, during the school hours, the speed limit in this area is 15 miles per hour, so I'd like to remind motorists about that.
Now, we've had a number of incidents right there on that particular curve. Is it because of speeding? What do you think it was about?
A combination of things. You have speed, you have persons who are not paying attention, you have persons driving defective vehicles with respect to their brakes, with respect to the condition of their tires.
Mm-hmm. Now, the unpaved trench that is on Shirley Street, how am I supposed to maneuver in the next lane without causing a backup?
Well, you have to ascertain that the way is clear and before maneuvering to the next lane. Ministry of Works, they have to do a better job with respect to their roadworks. When they dig these trenches, I think they do a poor job with respect to alerting the public that a trench is nearby. They have to put cones, and also one time ago they used to light these balls that would burn through the night, so motorists will be able to so the trench will be able to be visible to motorists. So they need to go back to basics, and on Nassau Street it's the same thing. They have to do a better job of putting up a light system so motorists can know that there's a trench or some obstruction up ahead.
Now, can you give us an update? Has anything happened overnight in the country that we need to know about in terms of traffic?
Yes, we had 23 crashes in the last 24 hours. 8 of those involve injuries. We have one person hospitalized. Also, we had one hit-and-run accident.
Now, we always talk about the hit-and-runs. Is the police beefing up and making sure that we identify those persons? Have anybody been brought to justice as yet in terms of those hit-and-runs?
Yeah, we had good success, but what is still plaguing us is that hit-and-run accident that would have occurred last week Wednesday on West Bay Street in the area of Fort Charlotte Station. We still haven't found that driver. The lady has since passed. And, you know, at this point, the driver should have already come in. You know, they should have passed the point of shock or fear during the time of the accident, which can occur sometimes when you crash. But at this particular junction, they should have already come forward. So if we were to catch that person, I think we have to make an example of that individual and send them to jail.
Now, you spoke about fear and leaving. If I leave the scene of an accident and head to one of the nearest police station, is that still considered hit and run, or how would you term it as a police officer?
No, it isn't considered hit and run. We may charge you with leaving the scene of an accident, but sometimes when you have these crashes, the environment might cause you to leave. Persons in the area might become hostile and may cause you want to leave to protect your own life and your own safety. So that happens from time to time, and we understand that. But persons who are not, who blatantly hit people, and they try to conceal the fact that they hit someone, and they also have help with persons who assist them in concealing their crime.
All right, thank you so much, Sergeant Jerron Thompson. Jimenita, that was a mouthful this morning, so we'll send it back to you. But we do have some tricks up our sleeve if you join us on the other side. Back to you in the studio, Jimenita.
Thanks, Kelsey. Education Minister the Honorable Jeffrey Lloyd reacting to the Inter-American Development Bank's report on Hurricane Dorian's impact on the effect on the local economy. And it says that the education sector saw damage in the amount of $72.4 million, with losses just over $6 million. Lloyd told reporters he's not sure how the IDB arrived at its figures, but he explained the preliminary assessments of education officials.
Initial estimate was in the $40 million range, but at the time that I made that announcement, I did say that the assessments were continuing. I should have better information with the assistance of the Ministry of Works by this Friday, so we could know what the entirety of the scope of repairs and rebuilding would be to the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Works.
Molloy has described the losses in Grand Bahama as severe, but noted that Abaco has been decimated. He outlined where he believes the funds will be derived for the repairs.
The government had taken a $100 million facility with the Inter-American Development Bank, which is going to be, at least a part of it is going to be applied to the rebuilding efforts. You also know that there has been significant donations made to this country by countries and NGOs and individuals from around the world. And of course, we are probably going to have to seek some other forms of revenue and for other forms of funding, such as possibly borrowing, but that will be decided by cabinet and it will be revealed in the appropriate time.
In other news, plans underway to step up security at Paderewski Dock following the sexual assault of a woman on the waterfront. The Minister of Transport and Local Government, the Honorable Renwood Wells, on the plans.
We're looking. There's security out at Paderewski. We're looking as to how we can increase 24-hour security. That's the issue. But we are looking into it. But again, you know, those kinds of matters too are matters that are for the police. There is a little small police station there on Paderewski. There was a development process going on at Paderewski for both lighting, for security, for new buildings. We have gone through upwards to phase two of that development. Phase three, obviously, I think a part of that was the CCTV cameras and others, and the government is still moving forward with it. We're also looking, as was said probably about a year and a half ago, as to how we can move with a public-private partnership for the complete operations of Paderewski.
Well, hundreds are now prepared to help police tackle crime. Participants of the Citizen Security and Justice Program are set to graduate this evening after completing a crime and violence training curriculum. The group, considered to be community leaders, participated in workshops over several days. They were provided with skills to effectively tackle social ills facing the country and mediate issues involving gender-based violence, sexual assault, conflict, and parenting. Well, in the Supreme Court, the prosecution has closed its case in the bribery trial of former cabinet minister Shane Gibson. Legal discussions will take place today, and jurors are slated to return to court on Thursday. Meantime, Gibson has denied all allegations against him. Well, stay with the Morning Edition. It's Universal Children's Day and what's being done on the home front. And of course, big plans announced for the Cascarilla industry in the Bahamas.
During a hurricane, intense winds and rains are not the main cause of window and door damage. The most serious threat to your family is flying debris. The official hurricane season runs from June 1st to November 30th, but hurricanes have been known to form in other months. We Buy You Sell is this region's number one supplier of high-impact windows and doors. Located at number 163 Robinson Road, call us at 324-6427 or 677-2856. Come and see us today. Right away.
Hepatitis is the inflammation of the liver, which is the organ responsible for filtering toxins from the body, producing bile for digestion, and producing proteins and clotting factors. The most important cause of hepatitis worldwide is viruses, of which there are five main types: A, B, C, D, and E. Hepatitis B and C are major health challenges globally, affecting over 300 million persons worldwide. The suspicion of hepatitis may be a challenge, as there are typically no symptoms. However, if infected, non-specific symptoms may include decreased appetite, nausea, vague abdominal discomfort, jaundice or yellow eyes, and abnormal liver function tests. If not treated, hepatitis of any type can lead to cirrhosis and liver cancer, which leads to over 1 million deaths worldwide. If you suspect you may have been exposed to the virus that causes hepatitis, Talk to your doctor today and get tested.
This public service announcement is brought to you by the Public Hospitals Authority in conjunction with the Medical Association of the Bahamas and the Broadcasting Corporation of the Bahamas.
Welcome back to the Morning Edition. Cascarilla bark is used in the production of Campari along with other medicinal purposes that utilize the oil and the bark. Both can be found in large quantities in the southern Bahamas, such as in Acklands, Crooked Island, and Samana Keys. The Acklands Islanders Cooperative is now active to aid in the development of this industry, while Lucrative only sees about $6 per pound. Chairman is Philip Williamson.
We've asked the government for 100 acres of land, because we don't want to start producing oil and find out, hey, we ran out of bark. So now we said we are going to plant 100 acres of land. Now for each acre of land, we need 1,000 plants. So for 100 acres, we need 100,000 plants. So right there, that's a new business. We will ask persons, hey, look, go and establish a nursery, and you come to us, the cooperative, and we will buy your plants because we have the 100,000 acres from 100 acres from the government. And so that in itself will do that.
Williams also highlights some areas that production can be enhanced.
The more we process it at home, the more value will be added at home, the more economic value will be accrued to the people there. And so now we are making that next move and saying, no, don't just send the bark off. Let's process it as far as we could. And then, because we're doing that, we'll create more jobs. That's why we are now calling this Cascarilla industry.
Well, over in Long Island, residents, fishermen, and businessman Roger Cartwright says in 2015, the island was battered by Hurricane Joaquin, and just a short 2 years later, Irma came to the southern island with a vengeance.
A lot of the fishermen have since bounced back. We lost the whole fleet of fishing boats, like the big motherships. We lost the full fleet. I think it was 10 in all. Since then, I think we probably got about 5 big boats up and running. They're the motherships that carry like 10 dinghies with them, so like 50 boats at a time. And I think the economy is coming back.
Well, while the island was returning to a state of normalcy for the fishermen, Chairman Chamber President, that is, Cheryl Diache, says networking and planning have been the key to restarting the business.
The Bahamas Chamber of Commerce helped and assisted quite a number of the fishermen here on the island that had their boats way up in the land, and in bringing in a company to have them taken off the land and put back into the water. And so they need to try and follow up now on these type of opportunities so that they can get back out there as quickly as possible.
Oh, well, the marijuana debate could be picking up across the country as the National Committee prepares to make its findings public soon. Meantime, the views vary across the board. This morning, we are hearing from a number of college students on whether or not they support the decriminalization of marijuana.
I think it should be decriminalized because not only would the government be successful in trying to raise some money around this place, but it'll stop a lot of gang violence and a lot of things what happening on the streets what people don't see going on, especially these young boys who smoke in today. It's like a coping mechanism for them.
Maybe if they gave it a chance, then possibly it could open up new avenues for us.
I think it should be sold and taxed because it's always a better chance to heighten the economy. And also, it would take a lot of black men out of prison.
You know, we do crops and planting and stuff. I feel as if this can be a lucrative business, especially for, you know, tourists coming to the Bahamas, because some persons like marijuana from, you know, different countries.
Maybe at certain dosages, it should be criminalized. No one should have too much of anything. And so I think if it's with the intent to sell, and it's not selling it, the person not selling it by any illegal avenues, I think that should be criminalized. But marijuana in itself, I don't think should be criminalized.
People may take it out of context, like, oh, they use it for, let's say, what, their mental health and what's not. But people may still abuse it and, you know, then overuse it, and then they would get high, as we would say, you know, to feel a different type of inner being.
Well, today, all around the world, people will be observing Universal Children's Day. And this morning, Anthony Smith has more on how children here in the Bahamas are celebrating.
Lunch starts with a freestyle and ends with a performance by the Royal Bahamas Police Band, the World Children's Day pop-up, of course. It's the inaugural event put on by the Ministry of Social Services and the National Child Protection Council, observing World Children's Day. Here, the kids are taught how to make the right decisions while meandering through school and life, but it's surely not your average lecture.
And rather than us doing just a normal chalk and talk thing, we decided that we wanted to do an activity that would be educationally engaging, rather than the chalk and talk. And so what our kids are exposed to is 10 booths that are done all by our sponsors.
The 10-booth symposium featured colorful talks on health, more serious discussions on child abuse, and lessons on the dangers of drugs from the men who fight crime themselves. And it seems those lessons were well received.
We was learning things, so when we grow up, that we wouldn't make the mistakes that the people made.
My favorite part was finding out what I have the right to do.
And dropping by the handsome added encouragement to the students was Minister of Social Services, the Honorable Frankie Campbell, who by all means was just as enthused as the students.
This is very important as we consider the youth of our nation important, as we consider the role that we're looking forward to them being able to play. It's very important for the children to know that they have value, that they are valued, they have a voice, and that time is taken out to pay attention to their concerns.
Here in the Bahamas and all around the globe will celebrate and learn more about the day carved out just for themselves. And while the pop-up event was the first of its kind, organizers say, based on the reception from kids especially, it won't be the last. Anthony Smith, ZNS Network News.
Thanks, Anthony. We have so much more coming up in the morning edition. Don't go anywhere.
The best of the best regatta, December 5th through 8th. See the best boats, the best crews, the best skippers all compete in the best harbor. And on land, the best onshore activities. With the action on the water and the fun on the shore, there's something for everyone. And at night, check out the best in Bahamian entertainment. It's the best of the best regatta, December 5th through 8th. Be there.
Colon cancer is the third most common cancer affecting Bahamians. Your risk of developing colon cancer is increased if you have a personal history of colorectal cancer or colon polyps, a family history of colon cancer, or inflammatory bowel diseases such as ulcerative colitis. Other factors that can increase your risk of developing colon cancer are low fiber, high fat diets, a sedentary lifestyle, obesity, smoking, and alcohol. You can take steps to reduce your risk of colon cancer by making specific lifestyle changes. Eat a variety of fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. These foods contain fiber, minerals, vitamins, and antioxidants, which may play a role in cancer prevention. Drink alcohol in moderation or not at all. Do not smoke. Exercise with a goal of getting in at least 30 minutes each day. If you've been inactive, start slowly and gradually build up to 30 minutes. Also, talk to your doctor before starting any exercise program. Maintain a healthy weight. If you're at a healthy weight, maintain it by combining a well-balanced diet with daily exercise. If you need to lose weight, ask your doctor about healthy ways to achieve your goal. Colon cancer screening can also help to prevent colon cancer or lead to its early detection when treatment is most effective. If you're 45 years or older, speak to your doctor about having a colonoscopy or some form of colon cancer screening that may be appropriate for you. I'm Dr. Eugene Marcus Cooper. Pay attention to your health. Get the facts and discuss colon cancer with your physician today.
This message is brought to you by the Ministry of Health in partnership with the Public Hospitals Authority.
Hey, y'all, what's up?
Hey, what's that?
What y'all getting?
Listen, I've been waiting to mash down some lobster, yeah?
Hi, I'm Matthew. I will be you guys waiter today. Can I take your order?
I've been juicing for some grouper dread.
Y'all see this?
See, this ain't gonna work.
Why the fish gone though?
But how though?
Don't leave our children with no fish in their future. Protect our sea. Protect our way of life. Protect the Bahamas. To learn how you can help, find us on Facebook at Bahamas Protected. See the future.
We shift now to offer you some educational tips. The Scholarship and Educational Loan Division offers 8 different scholarships. Acting Director of the unit, Julian Barrows, says an average of 4,000 students apply annually, but only a finite number are awarded. Barrows says the budget in 2018 was $14 million, and all of that was used. The acting director is suggesting that parents plan well ahead before students' final year in high school.
Actually, there's no free ride, even though you may get funding from the government. It's just an assistance, because even though your tuition may be covered, you need to set up your dorms, you need to secure your visa, you need monies for toiletries and other material. And so I would encourage those students and parents that they need to start saving. They wish their students to go abroad to college.
Well, administrators of the Public Scholars Program on Mackenzie also encourages investing in your child's tertiary education early, and the investment extends beyond money.
I would like to encourage parents and students alike to begin investing in preparing earlier. Because what we've seen is students who began the college preparation earlier are the ones who basically yield the greatest benefits. They're the ones who are getting the national merit and the All Bahamas merit. These are the ones who are doing stellar in their college admissions tests and BGCSEs. You know, some parents make the comment that they're making the investment at the front end to ensure that there's a saving in the back end.
The Bahamas National Trust will be putting on its annual Christmas jollification fundraiser this weekend at its Village Road location as the holiday season rolls in. Our Lloyd Allen has more.
So in 2 days, the 28th annual jollification is set to take effect right here at the Bahamas National Trust Village Road. I have with me the Deputy Executive Director, Lynn Gape, who is telling us a bit more about how this year's event is going to be spectacular.
Jollification actually is kind of special this year. A lot of people have said, well, what do you mean by jollification actually? Well, Love Actually, it's a play on that movie, which is a very well-known Christmas movie, more modern type Christmas movie, which is about love. And it starts out in an airport, and they're talking about how a lot of people think that airports are sad places. And then it said, well, it's not, because people are coming home and they're greeting loved ones and they're excited to see each other.
Gabe says while fundraising has remained a key focus of the event, community development remains a welcome spinoff. She says even the sponsors over the years have become a part of the BNT family at the event. So I know that this year, Commonwealth Bank, among other sponsors, are going to be taking part and assisting you with this event. How important do you think that sponsorship has been over the years?
The Jollification started out very small with only 20 vendors. It's grown to over 80 arts and crafts people, plus food vendors, plus, you know, a mistletoe lounge in the back with Bahamian Brewery and Bristol Wines and Spirits. And Commonwealth Bank actually came on and said, we will run your front gate, we will run your bank, we will count your money, we will sell your tickets. So not only are they a sponsor in a funding type of way, but Commonwealth Bank employees come and give service over the weekend event.
Not to be left out, Gabe says there remain an amazing lineup of community partners that help to bring Jollification to life every year.
We have, well, of course, Bristol Wines and Spirits, Bahamian Brewery, Summit Insurance, who help us by covering our security expenses for the event, Bahamia Rental, Asa H. Pritchard, who actually sponsor the children's crafts area. Alive is a new sponsor this year, and they're going to have a sip and paint area as part of Jollification. Also, Freedom Sound Productions, who do our sound for us for the event. So we have had very long-term sponsors.
As the event is set to start this Friday, beginning with the Members Night, Gabe says apart from a number of specialty bars, members will get first dibs on all the goodies at the event.
This year, Caribbean Bottling has a sparkling surprise for us. They're going to be launching a new product on the Friday night, and we're really, really excited to have that. Carla and Gabriella are very excited, and we're excited to have them use the event. But also, Bahamian Brewery on the Friday night is going to be talking about their commitment to rebuilding after Hurricane Dorian. They're going to be showing their new video about how they plan to rebuild their company, their support for their employees, their experiences. And people are going to be able to get a taste of the last of the pre-Dorian Sands beer.
And if you decide to come out on the weekend, she says there will remain lots of goodies for you and the entire family.
The event runs from 11 o'clock to 5 o'clock, Saturday and Sunday. It's 10 o'clock. $10 for the general public, $5 for BNT members, and then it's $3 for children over 5 and under 17. Just come and join us on the weekend and get some holiday spirit.
So this weekend, see you at Jollification, actually. For the Morning Edition, Lloyd Allen, ZNS Network News.
Thanks, Lloyd. It's what we're referred to as Wellness Wednesday. Our Kelsey Johnson joins us live with this special segment. Kelsey?
Good morning, Jim and Anita. Good morning, Bahamas. After a long weekend of strutting in some 6-inch heels, I needed to give my feet a break. So I decided to visit my good friend Henry Butler at Tab Therapy on Montreal and
Rosetta Street.
Now, Henry Butler, he's going to take me through a series of, what you call this, massages, reflex.
It's actually reflexology, but mm-hmm. it's done with magnetics.
Mm-hmm.
What we do is we place these magnetic contactors in the water, and the bottom of the feet, persons do not know, the bottom of the feet carry a lot of nerve endings. Actually, each foot has over 7,000 nerve endings.
Wow.
So what we're doing is we are sending electrical pulses via this wellness device. Mm-hmm. You know, this is Wellness
Wednesday, yes it is.
So this is a wellness device that has, it's based on the principles of acupuncture.
Mm-hmm.
Acupuncture is a very old method that is used for balancing the body, helps with promoting better sleep or energy. And like how you say, you got a long weekend, this is something that can rejuvenate the body, help to recover the body so you can get back into focus and work environment.
Mm-hmm. Now, how long should my feet be in the water and how strong will you make this magnetic?
Well, usually persons do their feet for about 30 minutes. We
okay.
also include the hands
mm.
because, again, it's overall balance of the body. Anything that affects your mind affects your body. Anything that affects your body affects your mind. So it's all about energizing the body, allowing the body to be in a more relaxed state for it to heal itself.
Now, I see on this particular card here, it shows us where, if I can just show Jim and Anita and the general public, how it works. Sinus, if you have a sinus infection, air, neck,
all of these things help?
The sinus glands are connected in the toes. Mm-hmm. If you go lower, it's like how the body's represented. You go into the heart, the lung region. And so as we send this pulse, we're using the water as a conductor of electricity. So this pulse is actually going through the whole system via the nervous system and energizing the brain, so it's bringing the body in a more relaxed state. So your glands can make more, almost like endorphins, mm-hmm. Melatonin, so you sleep better, more energy.
Mm-hmm. So is there any warnings before we get this started?
Well, anyone who especially a female, knowing that they're pregnant at the time, mm-hmm. they're not allowed to do the treatment.
But I'm not pregnant. Let's just put that out there.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you're not pregnant. And if you have a pacemaker, you're not allowed to do the system.
Okay.
But anybody else, with implants and their hip replacement, they still can do the treatment because all those persons still struggle from circulation problems. Mm-hmm. This treatment is designed to promote better circulation because you know that all the organs, the glands need circulation.
Yes, it does.
And in our stressful lifestyle a day, partying, working, whatever we do, we need to find time to relax our body. Mm-hmm. And that's what this is all about.
Okay, well, Henry, I am ready. Just don't turn it up too much because I don't know how I'm going to react. Woo! Okay.
So initially, you feel the sensation.
Yes,
so your brain
sensation.
Is trying to organize itself mm-hmm. to this pulse. Mm-hmm. It's a pulse, really. But some
I can feel something working.
Yes, yeah, so as it pulses, it sends signal to the brain. And if I intensify it, it actually moves the muscles in your calves. Mm-hmm. So it actually have to flush the lactic and the tension or the feet. Like you said, if you've been partying or mm-hmm. if you're working a job that you stand long, it's very good for that.
So when I put on my heels again this weekend, my calves will have more definition.
More definition.
Well, turn it up, Henry. I am, wasn't ready for that, but I am ready to wear some 6-inch this weekend. Henry, I can tell you that I can feel something tingling in the water. Whew.
And as you can see, you'll see her legs start to move. See, because the body, again, is the body is energy, so this is something that can promote better blood flow. That's our biggest problem with aging. Mm-hmm. And this is a wellness device, again,
based on principle.
Well,
Henry, are you trying to tell me I'm old?
No, this is not about disease. This mm-hmm. is about maintenance.
Okay.
Yeah, like how we do the exterior, the outside of the body. This is maintenance for the body.
Lyndon, I don't know if you can get it, but you can see my calves are starting to jump or twitch a little bit, as well as my feet in the water. Something's working. I can feel it. I can feel it. Oh, my gosh. It doesn't hurt. I don't want people in the general public to believe that I'm in pain.
You
can
pain.
Feel some electricity going through, some shock going through my body.
And then our body is based on, our body functions through electrical pulses. Because mm-hmm. our brain sends, make neurons and it sends messages throughout the body. So this works with the current of the body. My eldest client, by the way, is 105 years old.
Wow.
My youngest client is 106 years old. We work on most of the elite teams, like athletes in our country, from DeAndre Ayton to Sunshine Auto for years. That's why they've been getting back-to-back because they come in for recovery. Mm-hmm. The pitcher, basketball, Commonwealth Bank Giants, they're doing a backdoor sweep.
So, Henry, what you're telling me, if I come to you every week, I'll be jumping out of the gym, hitting a volleyball again.
You'll have more energy, more flexibility. Like I said, it helps your body to balance your hormones so you'll be more relaxed. And you already have the talent. It's just a matter of getting the energy back up.
Mm-hmm. And how much does a treatment like this cost? And how many times do I have to visit you?
Well, our treatment cost is 7 treatments. It's roughly $50 a treatment at mm-hmm. this time. It's something that you be giving you back control of your own wellness because it's bringing the body into a state of relaxation.
Mm-hmm. Lyndon, oh my gosh, it is working, Lyndon. You can see, look at my calf. My little calves are jumping. I feel like I'm going to be a multimillionaire. Like DeAndre Ayton, since Henry works on DeAndre Ayton and all the other. I remember coming here one time and sitting down on the side of Levan after he got injured after the 2012 Olympics.
Yeah, Levan, all of the athletes mm-hmm. who see the benefits of this, they come in on a periodic. All of Lucius Fox, Dallas Chisholm, all of them, even before they signed the contracts, they've been coming here for maintenance.
Mm-hmm. And what about the back and the shoulders, stuff like that?
Yeah, we can also take these probes out of the water. Mm-hmm. And we can actually apply them on the shoulder. So these probes can actually, once it's past water in contact with it, mm-hmm. it's able to massage the neck. We also have other devices. We have a massage table where we do this vibratory massage on the back, and it just frees up stress and tension on the body.
Mm-hmm. So how much longer do I have to keep my feet in here?
Well, we're doing just a few more minutes, and then you'll be finished. When you come out, you feel a difference in your body right away.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right away.
So I should have, like, Golden Girls feet.
Light and rejuvenated feet. Not just feet, rejuvenated body.
Rejuvenated.
More energy, but more relaxed.
And sexy.
And sexy to say
to put on my heels.
Yes, ma'am.
That's all I'm worried about because everybody knows I am 5'11", and I still love to wear some heels. And this hair, this therapy treatment, it's only going to last like 4 minutes. I have one more minute left, but it feels so good. I am going to do a stand-up later on for you, Jim Anita, in some heels, just going to strut to let you and the general public see exactly how this magnetic treatment works for me. Back to you in the studio, Jim Anita.
Thank you.
Well, thanks, Kelsey. Fisher is here, and he has definitely been singing the praises of that element that he says he's actually experienced twice, so it's worth its weight.
Yeah, you know, once ago I was a world-class athlete, and then
here
I
go again.
And to go for some treatment. I used to run 10.6 in the 100, but after using that, I went down under the 10 seconds. So it definitely works. It gives me a lot of boost, and I'm feeling good right now. So I'm thinking about going in there. I think you should do it, too.
I'll check it out. But what's coming up for us?
Coming up in sports, we're going to talk a lot of tennis. We're going to talk some basketball, some big tournaments coming to our shores. We have lots of Division I basketball athletes coming. We're also going to talk about Buddy Hield. You know, we can't leave him out as well.
Well, that sounds
just
like
get a boost. Get a boost.
A packed package coming up. Stay with us. Don't go anywhere.
Entire span of the Bahamas, there is a strategic spread of national parks which play a vital role in protecting the survival and well-being of diverse wildlife as well as Bahamian livelihoods. The Andrews Westside National Park, for instance, consists of thriving bonefish populations, the healthiest stands of red mangroves found in the Bahamas, breeding and nursery areas that support wildlife such as snappers, groupers, lobsters, and threatened and endangered species like marine turtles, the Andrews rock iguana, and the flamingo.
If we do not effectively safeguard our natural treasures, vital habitats, which include nursery and breeding areas, will become vulnerable to a number of threats impacting the way we live. We must remember to do our part to maintain the integrity of the natural environment. Remember, if we take care of nature, nature will take care of us.
As an artist, I travel all over the world and I find inspiration all around me. From the people, and especially the environment. I love the Bahamas with all its natural beauty. From Abaco in the north to Anagua in the south and all the wonderful and colorful islands in between. But we must all do our part to keep the Bahamas healthy and clean, now and for the future generations. That's why I want you to find a little time to do your part. I'm doing my part because I care. Do you?
Good morning once again, everybody. It's that time for sports, and we enter day three of the International Tennis Federation Gombe Splash going on at the National Tennis Center. Tonti and Brister moving on after an opening round match win over Peg and Zhang from China, 6-2-1. And we'll be right back on court today facing Liam Drova from Canada.
It's always good to start off the tournament with the win. Gain some confidence, get used to the tournament, to work yourself way in. So hopefully, I hope to improve on some things and to make it better for my next match.
You're familiar with this court. You've been playing good on the circuit. Must be an advantage in your favor.
I think I played a good amount of reasonable good matches for the year. So just use what I learned from the matches then and use it for this tournament.
What's it going to take for you to keep advancing and then get to the finals and keep the trophy home?
I'm a lefty, so I'm going to try to use that to my advantage. Serve good and be more aggressive with the forehand, dictate most of the points.
Tournament director once again is Mickey Williams, who has been putting together the schedule and the draws from the tournament was brought to our shores.
We have a total of 80 players between qualifying and main draw. The qualifying competition wasn't too big this year. Actually, all of the girls who entered qualifying ended up ultimately getting into main draw. And then we only had about 3 boys who didn't make it in. So, like I said, total of 80 players. 15 of those are Bahamians. I think it's one of the largest contingents of Bahamians we've had in recent memory.
Not only are the players on display this weekend, their talents are also on display. It's also giving Bahamian coaches and officials a time to shine.
We have a team of six officials running this tournament with me. And there's one assigned to each court. So there's always an official on court for all the matches. And so the players appreciate that. Sometimes in some of the places you go, there's one official for like 10 courts. And so they appreciate having somebody, not personal, but somebody attending their match in a personal capacity.
Bahamas Scholastic Association tipping off their basketball season Tuesday, running in primary boys action. Prince William Falcons sawed by the Cherubims of Telios 18-9, with Conde Smith leading the way with 9. Andrew Bethel at 7 in the loss. A pretty good game for both teams.
The win today, we made a couple turnovers, but I feel like if we can come more competitive at the next game, we got to work on our free throws, layups, and yeah, we'll be good.
About the game, we didn't have too much players, so we still did good. And I thank for everyone to come out, and I hope it's a better game next time, and we have a good game next time.
It's a good game today. A few little hitches here, but my boys were able to overcome the situation. Hopefully, we continue to grow in this game as young 11, 12 years old, and the future look pretty bright for the Princeville Falcons.
Buddy Hield and the Sacramento Kings getting revenge on the Phoenix Suns. The two teams played in the season opener with the Suns winning by more than 20 points. This time around, the Kings holding off the Suns 121-16. Buddy 12 points, 5 rebounds, and 4 assists for the now turnaround Kings, who face Brooklyn on Friday.
We enjoy everybody's success, and we love that about everybody. We love to share the ball. We love to play together, and that's big for us, and that's going to help us keep growing, and that's going to help us win ball games down the stretch. You know, from 0-5, it was crazy. You know, everybody's freaking out. You just had to relax and get one game. You know, I know we were better than what we were showing, and now we're showing everybody that we're a good team, and, you know, we have a good Brooklyn team to go play against on Friday.
Basketball Travelers Jungle Jam, that tips off this coming Friday in Bimini for the first time in a 3-year run. The tournament features both Division I teams, ladies and men. Sean McShane is the man behind the top-level run.
And this is a business trip for these teams. I mean, these games count, and it's wonderful to come down and experience a beautiful place and just the beautiful people and the things that the island of Bimini has to offer. But at the end of the day, man, this is where the job is getting done inside this gym. And so for this to be in 100% tip-top shape is vitally important for us. And listen, we're streaming these games live across the country. And so, you know, people, this is a great, you know, impression for people to sit there and say, man, look what's going on down in Bimini right now. So we take a lot of pride, as does everybody that's involved in this tournament. These tournaments and what we do is really, it's like the Google theory. It's the word of mouth. And so these coaches are quick to talk to each other, so that when we're out recruiting teams for next year and beyond, we'll say, hey, listen, call coach so-and-so, he was here. And they do that, and they have nothing but great things to say.
The 2019 Ready to Jump, this coming Friday, organizers have already planned on a 2020 tournament.
We're going to get back up to 8 men's teams next year. That was by design this year for us, peeling it back to 4 teams. That is because we're going to bring in a new format next year where we're going to start to bring down some high major men teams, and we're going to fill out that bracket with 4 mid-major teams. And so this year was by design, just to take a quick step back while we restructure. And next year is going to be super exciting because, you know, this has got the potential to grow to be an elite tournament like some of the others that are happening in this country right now.
And that's going to put a cap on sports. Basil Dean is coming back to let you know about this cold weather we've been having. And the warm-hearted, let me see, Jimenita, yeah, she's also coming back as well.
Welcome to Sunshine Auto, your hottest place on the planet for rims, tints, tires, and auto sales. We are your auto superstore for rims, Lexani, Azaras, Trueform, Weston, Lux, Fuel, track lights, tough, rough racing, velocity, mud, all-terrain, and low-profile tires. Cars, homes, and commercial window tinting. At Sunshine Auto, we put God first and customer is king. Blessed luck.
Latest news and highlights in Bahamian culture. Tune in to the new Junkanoo 242. Saturdays, 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. on the ZNS Radio and Television Network. Radio Bahamas 1540 a.m. on 104.5 FM and TV 13. Each week, hosts Arlene Nash Ferguson and Darren Bastiat engages listeners with some of the movers and shakers of Junkanoo and Bahamian culture. Don't miss Junkanoo 242. Saturday at 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. on the ZNS Radio and Television Network.
Hey, long time no see.
You hear me?
Long time no see.
Boiled fish, stew conch, I love it all.
Tourists come here to take our tours, experience our sun, sand, and sea, and they also spend money around town.
I used to see a bunch of hogfish around here, but nowadays, I hardly see any.
You protect one area, the fish do their thing, make a bunch of babies, that's spread all over the sea. What's the problem?
If we protect certain parts of our sea, it keeps all parts working right.
I was against that phase, but knowing what I know now, I totally agree with having marine protected areas.
I support marine protected areas.
We support marine protected areas.
Look for Bahamas Protected on Facebook.
Sign the petition. Sign the petition.
Final look at weather in the tropics. We have tropical storm Sebastian now packing winds of about 50 miles per hour. It's moving towards the northwest at 8 miles per hour, and it is expected to be caught up by this frontal boundary. And once that happens, Sebastian will turn towards the north and then eventually towards the northeast, meaning it will stay away from the Bahamas. So no problem for us at all. Now we have this weak frontal trough moving through the northwest Bahamas. That's providing some early morning cloudiness, but that will burn off as that system moves towards the southern. Leaving behind some cooler conditions. Our forecast for today calls for mostly sunny, a bit breezy in the afternoon with your high temperature getting up to 79 degrees. And tonight we're looking at mainly clear skies, pretty much on the cool side with a low temperature of 69. Extended weather forecast, lots of sunshine right through the weekend, taking us into the early part of next week. But we're keeping you below 80s, but things will start warming up on Saturday, if you can call it that. Temperatures remaining in the low 80s right through the middle of next week. Germanita?
Well, thanks, Basil. As you can see from our live tower shot, you just have a glimpse of what's happening on the streets of Nassau. Well, that's going to do it for the morning edition. I'm Germanita Swain. Have a great one, everyone.